Hello, Lenny.
Elise, we're walking in the woods of New Hampshire right now on a very sunny, and it looks warm, but actually it's absolutely freezing outside.
Lenny, it's balmy out here.
I think it really is. I think it's freezing.
Reminding me of summer.
Well, Elise, I don't know. This whole thing has been going on for so long.
It has been.
And one of the things that I think has been so remarkable, there have been many remarkable things, but I think one of the things, you know, kind of like we're thankful for it, is the quartet and that you've been rehearsing and performing.
Well, I'm thankful for the quartet too, Lenny.
Can you tell us your schedule? I think people would like to know.
Yeah, 5 days a week.
Yeah.
We're rehearsing just in the mornings. It's a little bit shorter than we usually do just because of the pandemic and not wanting to be in a space for too long, but we're, you know, masks, double masks now, and distanced.
Yeah, what's the distance? You know, because when I was doing chamber music, we always wanted our stands really close and our chairs. Does it make that much of a difference?
You do get used to it, but I look forward to being able to be closer.
Okay.
Like Rupert said the other day, you know, some concerts you get to and they've set up your chairs, and then the first thing you do is move them even closer just to give you even more just connection.
Yeah.
But, you know, you adapt.
Yeah.
So
you've picked a beautiful program.
We wanted to play a Haydn string quartet. We often will choose between Mozart and Haydn, and this was Haydn's turn.
Yeah.
And because Jesse is the newest member, we said, you know, Jesse, why don't you pick the Haydn string quartet? So he brought this one before us, and it was just beautiful. And when we looked online to see if there were many other recordings, there weren't that many.
Yeah.
And I thought, I wonder why people don't perform this quartet that often. And then we started playing. It's in B minor, but then a lot of it is in B major, which has so many sharps. I've stopped counting, really.
Yeah.
I just hopefully play them.
Yeah.
And then we realized this is why not many people play it, because it is actually very difficult to play it in tune and to get it together. It's also, it's oddly, fantastically beautiful, but it's wonderful. The slow movement is absolutely to die for.
Yeah.
It's all in B major, and I hope everyone enjoys it.
Yeah.
It's wonderful to work on it.
And then what's happening?
Caroline Maloney is the butterfly effect, and we're very lucky she's will be here on video to describe a little bit about that. It's a wonderful piece. It involves some timing of improvisation, which our quartet is not that used to, so it was really wonderful. She writes out these beautiful fragments that you can choose a little bit when you want to play and respond to each other. So that was a lot of fun. And then last is Shostakovich's third string quartet, which I've been wanting to play for many years, and it's
a great piece.
It's just a wonder.
It's a fabulous piece.
Yeah.
And this is the first of two concerts that the quartet is going to give. You have another one on May 2nd. So
if you say so.
I think it is on May 2nd.
Yeah, okay. You're the boss.
Which I think is amazing. Stop it. I think that's amazing that you're going to do two concerts.
We're excited.
And so if people want to find out the rest of our concerts for this year, go to our website. There's a flyer. We made this interactive flyer. Everything is there. Elise, thank you for standing out in the cold with me.
Yes, thank you.
And it really is cold. And have a good concert. Off you go.
I gotta go.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Caroline Maloney, and I'm the composer of the next piece you're going to hear on the program. The piece is called The Butterfly Effect, and it's four string quartet, but there's some other added surprises that you'll hear. The idea is, it comes from chaos theory. The butterfly effect is that a very small change could have huge ramifications. So if a butterfly beat its wings in South America, somewhere on the other side of the world, there might be a rainstorm. So I try to bring this to life musically in this piece. You'll hear sort of fluttery sounds at the beginning imitating the butterfly's wings. And then you will hear sort of a journey. It will take you on a journey to a different place far away where perhaps it is raining. This piece was written for the Spectral Quartet and actually received its premiere in New Hampshire. So I am so happy to have this virtual return to New Hampshire. I'm so excited that the Apple Hill String Quartet is going to play it for you, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. On December 16th, 1946, Dmitri Shostakovich premiered his third string quartet in Moscow. 1 year after the horrors of World War II ended, and the same year that Boris Pasternak commenced writing his novel Dr. Zhivago, this would be the only piece of music that Shostakovich would write that year, foreshadowing hidden anxieties and troubles. It would soon come to pass that the Stalin regime would double down on their efforts to keep a righteous patriotic society and thus started to oppress the arts and the sciences. The third quartet would soon fade from existence just months after its premiere. We start the five-movement quartet with a somewhat jovial and ironic melody that, in time, increases in its unrest, the word of the day, and culminates in a double fugue. The unrest continues to start in the second movement with a E-G-B note ostinato in the viola. Things take a turn with the mouse-like movements as tempo grinds to a slow pitter-patter and finishes off with even more unrest that sets the tone for kinetic, frenzied fervor of the third movement. The wail of the movement seems at times to pay homage to the devastation of the just-finished World War. The long-lasting and brutal effects of the conflict on the land and its people is pieced together in the heart-rending funeral march melody of the fourth movement. This melody takes many forms throughout, ending in a grief-stricken state as the unrest and disbelief finally start to consume the music, culminating in fragments of melodies, phrases found and lost, a sinisterly comical yet purely Russian melody. All this leads to our final F major chord, a woeful violin melody, and the small glimmer of hope that our period of unrest is finally over. Thank you.